Hey guys, it's me, Luckpilly18, and I have a dice collection. Ooh, is this video gonna be about dice? Well, kind of. It's more about geometry. To be specific, it's about isohedral figures. Aren't you going to ask what those are? I already know what an isohedral figure is. Well, the viewers probably don't, so let me explain.
In geometry, a tessellation of dimension 2, a plane tiling or higher, or a polytope of dimension 3, a polyhedron or higher, is isohedral or face transitive if all its faces are the same. More specifically—
Are you reading off of Wikipedia right now?
Maybe.
Don't judge me. I wasn't judging you. Okay. Anyway, let me tell you a story. When I first started collecting dice a couple years back, I stumbled across a die that had 120 faces. I didn't know that many faces could fit on a die, and that made me curious. From that day forward, I vowed to get revenge on that ice cream man. Oh, wait, wrong story. From that day forward, I devoted myself to finding the maximum number of faces that a fair die or isohedral figure can have. The manufacturer's website said that 120 was the most sides you could fit on a die, and I just wanted to prove them wrong.
Hey, what gives, man? Play the piano correctly.
You can't control me. I do what I want.
Whatever.
Okay, so you said you wanted to prove that 120 was not the most sides that a die can have. Well, did you do it?
Yeah, it's actually pretty easy. If you stack two pyramids against each other, you can actually keep adding sides infinitely. Look at this D124! But this thing is kinda cheap, and I wanted a real answer, so I started looking for patterns in other dice. Whoa! Oh. Hey, I got a perfect 124. Awesome. Hey, can you press that button?
Okay.
Wow. These are the platonic solids. They're the only convex regular isohedral figures that have all their vertices adjacent to the same number of faces. Also, they make good fair dice. The fairest of the fair, if you will. Stop that. And the most important thing about these little guys...
Hey, I'm not a little guy! I'm a big guy!
The most important thing about these normal-sized isohedral figures is that pyramids can be added onto their faces to make even more complicated shapes.
Oh no!
Now this cube has 24 sides, and this is still a fair die because the original cube had regular faces. Oh, so pyramids must be how the D120 was created. Yep. If you just look at this thing, you can see pyramid structures based on the 12, 20, and 30-sided dice. Essentially, pyramids are the key to making dice with lots of sides. If I want to break the record for most sides on a die, I must harness the power of the pyramids.
Oh, is that why you're holding the magical pyramid staff? No, that's for personal stuff.
What I'm really getting at here is that I just need to find a fair die with a lot of regular sides, and then I can put pyramids on each face until the number of faces is greater than 120. And then I can finally bask in my glory, knowing I've made a significant contribution to mathematics by discovering/inventing a new isohedral figure. A good contender for the victim of my pyramid strategy happens to be a variation of the 60-sided die, the pentakis dodecahedron. As the name implies, it's based off of the normal dodecahedron with added pyramids. These triangle faces look equilateral, but they're actually isosceles, so I can't put pyramids on them just yet. This thing has to have equilateral triangles for the pyramids to work, so how do I change the faces without warping the shape of the die? Well, let me show you. These five faces form the pyramid. There are 12 of these, but let's just look at one for now. The cool thing about these pyramids is that no matter how the height changes, the faces will still be the same relative to each other. That means there's a specific height which makes these five triangles equilateral. And that height happens to be equal to... time to do the math.
I found the height. Hooray!
It's been 2 hours. Math is hard when you do everything wrong. Now let's get to the point. And the point is...
my perfect pentagon pyramid is finally complete!
And now that there are equilateral triangles on here, we can do another pyramid scheme. Now I just have to put it back together, and then I'll have the 180-sided die. That's 12 times 5 times 3. And now it's time for you to hit the other button.
Okay.
The subscribe button.
Okay, but do you still want me to press the button? Oh yeah. Press the button, please.
Here it is! Wait, it's concave. Oops.
What's wrong with that?
Well, since it's concave, it doesn't settle on its faces under gravity. It settles on the groups of vertices that jut out more than the rest. I mean, it's still an isohedral figure with more than 120 sides, but as a die, it's just a glorified d20.
Could make for some good merch.
I don't think anyone's gonna buy that. But hey, back to the math stuff. You know what this thing can do?
What?
Well, the triangle pyramids can also have equilateral triangle faces, so you can add tetrahedral pyramids to those too. Now it has 540 sides, and you can do it again too, but then the faces will overlap themselves. Look at the 1620-sided die. Or the 4860-sided die.
These are the kinds of dice that you would use when you play against death for your soul.
And all those faces are still equilateral, which means someone more insane than me could keep going forever!
Are you more insane than yourself?
Nope, I'm just as sane as I am. That's why I'm stopping. See you later, crocodile.
Hey guys, it's me,